Hi, how are you and thanks for joining. Today we're going to speak about the two different hotter stations that JBC carries. We have the JT-TE. It's the same station, it's a modular station, where the JT is a 700 watts, and either if you attach the precision hotter station, or you can see the difference here in size. When you attach this hose, the station goes from 700 watts to 300, so it's a little more precision. However, we have something even better, the brand new JNA. This is a brand station that we launched, I would say, a couple of months ago. And this station, there's nothing in the market as this. Before, when you try to rework, for example, an 01005, 0201s, if you try to do it with a hotter station, you're going to blow away everything. Thanks with this one is that the airflow, it's a 0.15 liters per minute, and it can go all the way to 2.5. But it's not enough force to blow away a 0201, for example. The way that it works, it will be the following. As soon as I pick up the handle, the unit will turn on, and there will be a red light letting you know that the unit is functioning, okay? You will come close to the component, you will refill the component, and you will remove the component. You will clean the pad, and then thanks to another novelty, DPM-V, you will put some solder paste in the pads, okay? And then, you will put, then with our T260 beacon plates, that, by the way, we have different syringes, okay, depending on the size of the component. You're able to pick up the component, place it on the pad, and then come with a hotter station, close, and by the capillary action, the component will position itself. But keep in mind that this station, it's at 70 watts, okay? So it's always advisable that if you're working with heavy ground planes, multi-layer boards, try to combine it with a preheater, okay? It's always really advisable. The nice thing is that this station goes from 150 to 450°C, okay? So you will have enough temperature to reflow components. JBC right now has only one heater. It's a 1 millimeter heater, but in the future we'll develop in other heaters from different sizes. As you can see here, I don't know if you guys, me, when I'm trying to rework really fine components, if I drink a cup of coffee, I'm going to be shaking around. JBC developed a hand support. The way that it works, it helps a lot to stabilize your pulse rate and not to shake. Okay, so you will come here, close to the board. And not only it will help to protect your palm from the preheater, also to be really precise. Going to its big brother, okay? For example, you've seen other hotter stations in the market. Okay, so for example, if you're trying to rework a QFN, imagine at 350°C, how do you know what's the temperature on that component? You don't know. The only way that you can know is if you put an external thermocouple there. JBC is the first company that created a unit with an external thermocouple. Well, the thermocouple in the hose and the external thermocouple K-tape communicate and makes a loop in between both of them. It comes with two modes, the protection mode and the regulation mode. Imagine the protection mode, okay? Imagine that you're working with a QFN, QFP, okay? And next to it, there's an MLCC or a heat-sensitive component that it can crack to, let's say, 200. You can attach the thermocouple nearby that heat-sensitive component, and if the temperature reaches to 200, the station shuts off. The regulation mode is what I was explaining a little before, is that you can attach, imagine, 350, and 350 on the thermocouple. The way that it works is that you place the thermocouple in the QFN, and it doesn't matter how close or far you are, the station will deliver more power or less power, more airflow or less airflow, having always 350 in that component. The nice thing also as well is that this station has, as you remember, there's a suction pump, right? So we have a suction pump here, where we have these little tripods and these little extractors, where, for example, this, you have like a little IC. Okay, you can stick the component, and it will stick to the component. You start reflowing, and once the component is reflowed, it will pop up for you. You don't have to be trying to use a pair of tweezers, for example, and trying to lift it up, and maybe damaging the board, okay? The station as well has more than 20 profiles, so I don't know if you've seen this arm, it's a pretty nice arm. The way that it works is the following. If you have a repetitive board, what you can create is a profile. This arm is an XY arm, okay, so you can put it side by side, and you will place it create the profile and have the same consistency and repeatability. Okay? And as well as my advice, try to always combine as much as possible with a preheater. That will benefit in trying to decrease the temperature on the board, on the hose, sorry, and then have a better rework solution. Thank you so much. If you want to try a demo, feel free to ask, and let's see you in another video.